In this view, we will be demonstrating the AP hip. The AP hip should be performed with the patient lying supine on the table, with a 40-inch source-to-image distance and no tube angulation. I have my patient on the table supine, and the IR is in the bucky tray. All of my locks are engaged. I am set at 40 inches SID. For this particular view, we need to create a plane from the aces to the pubic symphysis and draw that plane, and then from there, you're going 2.5 inches down, and I'm gonna hold my finger right there. We're gonna float the table right over that spot. We're gonna collimate. We're gonna place a marker, a right marker here on the side. We want to invert her toe 15 to 20 degrees with her heels 8 to 10 inches apart. That will help elongate the neck of the femur and put that greater trochanter in profile. We want to suspend respiration, hold the patient really still, and then the exposure is made. A diagnostic AP hip radiograph must be free of motion and rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include the hip joint and proximal 1/3 of the femur. Greater trochanter in profile with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating an AP unilateral frog hip. The AP unilateral frog hip should be performed with the patient lying supine on the table with a 40-inch source-to-image distance and no tube angulation. I'm going to have the patient bend both knees. I'm going to let her right leg fall open towards the affected side, and I'm going to roll her through the hip just a little bit. We're going to use that same plane from the aces to the pubic symphysis, but we're going to center right on the plane this time. So the central ray right here, and it's at the crease or the fold of the leg. So if you folded her leg, it's about right there. We're going to keep that collimation at 10 by 12. I'm going to use that right marker still here in the light. The patient will suspend respiration, hold very still, and the exposure is made. A diagnostic AP unilateral frog hip radiograph must be free of motion. Demonstrated anatomy to include the hip joint, acetabulum, and femoral head with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail.
If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.